know. But I'm going to be pouring some resin. Now, the thing with resin is it has to be equal parts, okay? So what I've done is I've taken two of these little plastic cups, and I took my ruler, and I went 3/4 of an inch. I very, very, very carefully put the edge of my ruler on the cup, and I hold it really tight, and then I mark at 3/4 of an inch right there. I put a little mark. And then I did it twice on two of these cups. And then when I was done, just to make double sure, I went like this and put them together and made sure that they matched. I want to stop right at that line. If I stop below it, I got to stop below it on this one. If I stop above it, I got to stop above the line on this one. Perfect. You're going to need an extra cup for this too, because you're going to have to pour this into another cup. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pour, was it the resin into the hardener or the hardener into the resin? Let me just look. Resin. The hardener is going to go into the resin. This is the resin. Okay. And you're going to need two of these sticks. Okay, so you're going to take them. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put this silicone mold. It's supposed to be like a geode kind of a thing, you know, and I'm going to put this, I'm going to pour some of it in. The majority of it in. And so I have these alcohol inks. Now this alcohol ink was from Temu. And this is emerald green. And all you do is you take just a few drops in a circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think I'll do 5. I need more. I can always add more. This color is indigo, so it's a nice. I'm going to take a little stick and stir it all about. I'm going to take one. Okay, so I want to show you a cool trick that I learned. I think that this rose gold looks really, really pretty with this. So I'm going to use the rose gold inside of this piece. And I'm going to use the smaller pieces. I'm going to fess up. I did one and I did it with the starfish right in the middle. It's not good for making a coaster. You need something that's going to be more shallow, that's going to go down in when you put the rest of the resin on top. It's going to cover it, and you want it to lie flat if it's a coaster, correct? So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this little shell right here, and I'm going to take some of the, I'm going to do the seahorse and these shells here. And on top of that, I have some of this gold leaf. I have gold leaf, and I keep the little bits and pieces of it. I want to take a little lighter. You can take a torch, or you can take a lighter, whatever works for you. And if you go over it like this, it gets rid of all your bubbles, and it stays nice and smooth. It's so. I have this cute little resin mold that I got from Temu, and it's just a little cameo, so I'm going to fill that baby up, don't you know? I'll fill it up. It's really... Okay, this one's nice and shiny. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to paint the sides of this. The this pretty.
He did.
Isn't that? I'm gonna blow dry it just for a second. Okay, what I'm gonna do with this is I'm gonna just slide it over some. SOS. Right over here. And I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do. I bought a candlestick from Hobby Lobby the other day. What I want to do, so I blinged it just around the edge with the Aurora Borealis SS20 bling.
What I did was I took a disc, just a wooden round that I had in my stash,
okay? And all I did was I put this dead center like this, and I drew a circle around it, just like that. Boom. Drew a circle. Then I took my ruler and I just eyeballed. Then I mixed up some paint. And all these three colors gave me this color. Okay? Like sand. And then I just dabbled around like this. I wanted it to look like a beach. Okay. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to take this kind of a chippy brush. I want to make like little flecks of sand, you know, or dirt. I'm going to use some E6000 because this is heavy. I got this, y'all. I got this real starfish. I'm not going to attach this, and I'm going to set it right here. Now, I also made, because I had a little extra resin yesterday, I have these, and I got these from the Dollar Tree. Yes, the Dollar Tree sells these kind of resin type things, and look at how stinking cute this turned out.
But
I'm going to utilize this on this tray, okay?
So
if I did this like this, and then I took our cute little resin piece and I attached it here, but what I want to do with this bowl, you know what I want to do, right? I want to drop the same colors of alcohol inks down inside this bowl, dry it, and attach it to well, I'm not going to attach
it.
Take some of these inks. And I'm going to just start dropping them. This is going to be attached to that in a moment, but I'll show you. We're going to flip it over. I'm going to use the B7000 around the edge of this. Now, I've gone over this with alcohol inside and out to make sure that it was all nice and clean. Gonna push it down really good. All right, now I'm going to take some of these pieces. I'm going to take the sea turtle. I'm probably going to use it in this mix here. I'm probably going to have them hanging off the side here. I'm just gonna make like a little beach scene going on. This is on pretty good. All these are on pretty good. Let's just see what it all looks like when we put it together. Okay, ready? There we go. Isn't that pretty?
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.